Museum and Convention Center. The 29th annual Miss USA pageant.
From the whole of this great USA.
Our winner over $75,000 in cash and prizes.
Sailing through the waters of the bay, Miss USA, Miss USA.
From this lighthouse, you get a truly panoramic view of the Mississippi Gulf Coast and of the lovely city of Biloxi. Good evening. I'm Mary Therese Friel, 1979 Miss USA. But from up here, I can't show you the excitement that's building at the Mississippi Gulf Coast Coliseum and Convention Center, where tonight a new Miss USA will be chosen and crowned. Let's go there now and join Jane Kennedy.
Thank you, Mary. You know, just before a Super Bowl game or any big competition, the tension begins to build as the start of the event grows closer. And everybody feels it, both in the audience and backstage. Our hosts, Bob Barker and Helen O'Connell, are busy with last-minute preparations. And so is our special guest, Donny Osmond. Seated next to the computer terminals, our judges are ready to start making their decisions, which will result in the selection of the new Miss USA. And the excitement is felt most by the girls themselves, who know that one of the most important evenings of their lives is about to begin. In fact, it's gonna start right now.
And here they are, from each of the 50 states and the District of Columbia, the most beautiful girls in the USA.
Here we come.
Our special guest tonight is one of America's favorite singers. Reporting on our computer results, the beautiful actress and the hostess of CBS's NFL Today, Jane Kennedy. And our host, the beautiful and talented singing star, Helen O'Connell. And the star of The Price is Right and one of America's favorite television personalities, Bob Barker. Escorting and serenading our ladies, here are members of the United States Marine Corps and the Naval Air Training Command Choir.
Beautiful women, we're both flying high. Beautiful women, each longing to try to write her name across.
Parker.
Thank you, and welcome to one of America's favorite vacation lands, the Mississippi Gulf Coast. And just in case the southern accents and the magnolia trees didn't convince me I was in the deep south, let me tell you that to get from my hotel to this Coliseum each day, I have to pass the former home of Jefferson Davis. I mention this so you'll know when I say hello from Dixie that we are really in Dixie. We really are. And from all 50 states and the District of Columbia, young women have gathered here tonight so that one of them might be chosen Miss USA 1980. To the winner goes more than $75,000 in cash and merchandise, plus the opportunity to represent the United States when young women from some 80 countries compete for the title of Miss Universe in Seoul, Korea on July 7th. Now, we know that everyone looking in is either rooting, judging, or both. And this is an ideal evening for you would-be judges because you'll not only see everything that our judges here see, but you'll have access to information they won't have. We'll explain a little later how that works. But for now, judges, here and at home too, let's meet our 51 candidates wearing their state costumes in the Miss USA Parade of States.
Pamela Regas, Troy, Alabama.
Debbie Pickens, Fairbanks, Alaska.
Janine Ford, Gilbert, Arizona.
Susie Owens, Jacksonville, Arkansas.
Carrie Lloyd, Thousand Oaks, California.
Shelly Marks, Littleton, Colorado.
Christine Wilson, Farmington, Connecticut.
Karen Jobby, Hockessin, Delaware.
Marianne Ritter, District of Columbia.
Barbara Bowser, Miami Springs, Florida.
April Reed, Augusta, Georgia.
Carol Ching, Kaneohe, Hawaii.
Marta Vincent, Boise, Idaho.
Karen Marie Grout, Princeton, Illinois.
Susan Osby, Hebron, Indiana.
Laura Kaminga, Keystone, Iowa.
Lisa Boyd, Wichita, Kansas.
Lisa DeBelli, Owensboro, Kentucky.
Kelly Boney, Baton Rouge, Louisiana.
Victoria Elias, Benjamin.
Tanya Walker, Kingsville, Maryland.
Diane Campbell, Melrose, Massachusetts.
Tina Hammonds, Troy, Michigan.
Carla Peterson, Albert Lea, Minnesota.
Sherry Brown, Meridian, Mississippi.
Kelly Laxson, Kansas City, Missouri.
Robin English, Great Falls, Montana.
Becky Staub, Ralston, Nebraska.
Kimberly Guider, Las Vegas, Nevada.
Eva Dyer, Amherst, New Hampshire.
Joni Piper, Franklinville, New Jersey.
Kathy Patrick, Anthony, New Mexico.
Deborah Sue Maurice, New York City, New York.
Lori Boggs from Kannapolis, North Carolina.
Kimberly Thompson, Minot, North Dakota.
Kim Thomas, Cincinnati, Ohio.
Martha Stradoff,
Norman, Oklahoma.
Marta Benedict, Salem, Oregon.
Andrew Patrick, Connellsville, Pennsylvania.
Robin Hall, Pawtucket, Rhode Island.
Sean Weatherly, Sumter, South Carolina.
Jane Schmidt, Flanders, South Dakota.
Diane Hunt, Etowah, Tennessee.
Barbara Buckley, Midland, Texas.
Carson, Salt Lake City, Utah.
Judy Winn-Nason, Randolph, Vermont.
Kelly Humphrey, Hampton, Virginia.
Janet Brown, Seattle, Washington.
Linda Hedrick, Wally Ford, West Virginia.
Susan McGaffigan, Pewaukee, Wisconsin.
Susie Harris, Casper, Wyoming.
51 beautiful ladies. One of them will be Miss USA of 1980.
Hello. Well, have you picked your winner yet? I don't envy the judges their job tonight, but you at home should have a lot of fun. The judging here is done with the aid of a computer. The girls are judged in three categories, swimsuits, evening gowns, and personal interviews. Each judge awards each girl a point total anywhere from 1 to 9.99 in each department. Then the computer takes over. To tell us about how that works, here's a beautiful young woman from CBS Sports who was once Miss Ohio, my home state. Right here in our pageant, Miss Jane Kennedy.
Hi, Jane. How you doing, Helen? I knew there was something I liked about you, Ohio.
It's mutual.
Well,
Thank you very much, everybody. Well, the judges feed their scores to the computer. The computer feeds an average score for the contestant. And those scores will appear on our tote board here so that throughout the entire pageant, you'll have an idea which girls are scoring best with the judges.
Well, but as Bob mentioned, that's where you will have an edge on our judges. They won't know any scores but the ones they personally give. They won't see or hear the computer figures. That will be available only to you. Jane will be analyzing and reporting on those figures during the evening.
And Helen will be visiting the judges' box, backstage with the girls, and a whole lot of other places. And I hope this lady's going to sing for us tonight. Please.
Oh, we'll see about that. Okay. I don't know about that. But in the meantime, we have a very special swimsuit event coming up from you. But first, let's listen to this word from Head and Shoulders.
To select Miss USA from among these 51 outstanding young women in one evening would be both impossible and unfair. So during the past week, we have had several preliminary events in which the judges gave scores to the contestants in three categories of competition. Here at our special Computer Central is Helen O'Connell to tell you what happened to those scores.
Well, during the preliminary judging, consisting of the interview, the swimsuit, and the evening gown competition, scores were put in right into this computer here. This keyboard is how we talk to the computer and tell it what we want it to do. The 12 ladies who achieve the highest average scores in those three categories will be Miss USA semifinalists. But before that, before we reach that point in the evening, there's something we'd like you to see. We have combined the beauty of the Mississippi Gulf Coast with a swimsuit fashion show. As each contestant appears on the screen, you'll see the average of the judges' votes for her in the swimsuit preliminaries. Remember, that's one-third of the figure used to determine the top 12. After you've seen our fashion show, we'll add in the other two-thirds, the evening gown and the personal interview scores. And then we'll discover the names of this year's 12 semifinalists. Is that clear, and are we ready, Bob?
Thank you, Helen. We are ready, and that is clear, yes. Wearing the latest and exciting Catalina fashion swimwear, here are 51 gorgeous young ladies and the lovely background of Mississippi. In the background, the Mississippi Gulf Coast Coliseum. In the foreground, a vintage-style Gulf Coast schooner, the Corsair. And aboard the Corsair, a very special crew of Miss USA candidates, including Miss Wisconsin, Susan McGaffigan, and Miss Louisiana, Kelly Bonin. Susie Owens, Miss Arkansas, and Miss Connecticut, Christine Wilson. Miss Montana, Robin English, and Marta Vinson, Miss Idaho. Miss Indiana, Susie Osby, and Miss Mississippi, Sherry Brown. Miss North Carolina, Lori Boggs, and Linda Hedry, Miss West Virginia. Fishing piers are plentiful in the Waveland area of the Gulf Coast, and a fish would probably like to be caught by a beautiful girl like Miss Massachusetts, Diane Campbell, Miss Ohio, Kim Thomas, and Tina Hammonds, Miss Michigan.
She's big and she's strong and she's mighty.
Miss New Jersey, Joni Pfeiffer, and Jane Schmidt, Miss South Dakota. Miss Pennsylvania, Andrea Patrick, and Miss Kentucky, Lisa Louise DeVille. Becky Staub, Miss Nebraska, and Kathy Patrick, Miss New Mexico. Miss Kansas, Lisa Boyd, and Miss Oklahoma, Martha Stradoff. Now we move down the coast a little and find that building castles in the sand is not restricted to little children. Here, some big girls have built some big castles, which provide a unique background for this group of lovely ladies, which includes Miss Alaska. Here she is, Debbie Ficus. And Miss Iowa, Lori Kraminga. Judy Wynn Mason, Miss Vermont. and Carrie Jobby, Miss Delaware. Miss Maryland, Tanya Walker, and April Reed, Miss Georgia. Miss New Hampshire, Eva Dyer, and Miss Virginia, Kelly Humphrey. Carol Lee Ching, Miss Hawaii, and Sean Nichols Weatherly, Miss South Carolina. The Gulf Marine State Park is our next stop. It's a combination museum, aquarium, and fishing spot, and it proved a delight to visitors like Miss Florida, Barbara Bowser, and Kelly Ann Laxon, Miss Missouri. Diane Hunt, Miss Tennessee, and Miss Wyoming, Suzanne Harris. Shelley Marks, Miss Colorado, and Kimberly Thompson, Miss North Dakota. Miss Utah, Tamara Parsons, and Miss California, Carrie Loy. Janine Ford, Miss Arizona, and Marianne Ritter, Miss District of Columbia. And now for our final stop. For more than 100 years, on the shore of the Gulf of Mexico, has stood this magnificent house. It takes its name from the poet Longfellow, who, according to legend, was staying here when he wrote his poem, The Building of the Ship. Our Longfellow House visitors include Deborah Sue Maurice, Miss New York. Here she is. And Miss Maine, Victoria Elias. Barbara Buckley, Miss Texas. And Kimberly Guider, Miss Nevada. This is Miss Alabama, Pamela Regas. And Miss Washington, Janet Brown. This is Miss Oregon, Marty Vidasich, and Robin Hall, Miss Rhode Island. Here come Karen Marie Grote, Miss Illinois, and Miss Minnesota, Carla Peterson. The operable word here certainly has to be beautiful. This beautiful house, birthplace of beautiful poetry, provides a background for 51 beautiful young women who will never forget the Mississippi Gulf Coast. And it's time now for the first big step in the judges' decision-making process, the choice of our 12 semifinalists. Now, earlier you saw the preliminary scores for each girl in the swimsuit competition. Now the computer has added the scores each girl received for preliminary judging in personal interviews and evening gowns. What the computer has come up with are the names of our 12 semifinalists. Now, may I have that list of 12 semifinalists, please, Mr. Wagner? Thank you, sir.
Now remember, the names will be called at random, in no particular order. So, if you watch closely, you'll see which girls have scored highest with the judges so far. Go ahead, Bob.
Before I read these names, let's welcome back, in their lovely dresses by Vicki Vaughn, our 51 candidates for the title of Miss USA! Now, before I announce the names of our 12 semifinalists, I would like to have you meet someone who has a very important message for our girls. The Korean sponsors for the Miss Universe pageant in July will be the newspapers Hankook Ilbo and the Korea Times. With us tonight is the distinguished journalist who is the chairman of those papers, Mr. Chang Kang-shae. Now, Mr. Chang's message is that not just Miss USA, but each of you 51 girls is invited as his company's guest to come to Korea for the pageant. And that's what I call a gracious host. On behalf of the girls, Mr. Chang, thank you. Thank you very much. Now, the contestants have not seen any of the preliminary scores, so of course, they have no idea the names that I have here on this list, which I am about to read to you. They are the 12 semifinalists for the title of Miss USA 1980. And as I call each name, you at home will see the contestants' total preliminary scores on your television screen. Now, girls, before I read the first name, I want to wish you all luck. It's been fun working with all of you. The 12 semifinalists. First name, Miss Nebraska. Number two is Miss Arizona. Ladies and gentlemen, how do you like Miss South Carolina? Our next semifinalist is Miss Minnesota. And come on down, Miss Texas. Way there with Miss Florida. And now we want Miss Alabama. From the great Southwest, here comes Miss New Mexico. The next name on our list of 12 semifinalists is Miss Maryland. Here we are at number 10. It is Miss New Hampshire. I have only two names left on this card. Only two more girls who have a chance to become Miss USA. And one of them is Miss Kentucky. Now we're down to number 12, the last name on the list. It is Miss New York. Congratulations to all of you semifinalists. It won't be long now, and one of you will be Miss USA of 1980.
Jane, you're certainly no stranger to computers or to tote boards or anything like that. Why don't you tell us about this
one? Well, Helen, in this particular tote board, the 12 semifinalists reached this position by achieving the 12 highest average scores from our judges in three categories: swimsuit, evening gown, and personal interviews. You guessed it. Those scores are posted now, and they show us that Miss South Carolina is in the number one position with a 9.085. And that's pretty high right now, because you'll see Miss New Mexico in second place has an 8.997, Miss Florida with an 8.924. Helen?
That is close. But now, as your friends at CBS would say, Jane, it's a brand new ball game.
Ah, right? You've been talking to Brent, I can tell. The scores you're looking at enabled us to determine which girls made the semifinals. But now we throw all of those scores out, and we start all over again with everybody even. It is a brand new ball game. Pageant. With 12 contestants instead of 51.
Well, if we're starting fresh, then let's have the tote board start fresh, too. Let's erase the numbers on it right now.
Okay. Go bye-bye.
They did.
It only did it when you did it.
And remember, if your favorite semifinalist had the highest score, or the 12th highest, or the lowest, or somewhere in between, right now, she's starting out even. And she just might be our winner.
That's right. As the judges rate our remaining 12 girls, their scores will be going up right here for you to see. And it's important, I think, to remember that while you'll be seeing those scores at home, the judges won't, and neither will the girls. We'll be posting the scores they receive for their interviews with Bob Barker, which are coming up next, as well as their interviews for the swimsuit and the evening gown segments that you'll see later in the show. The five ladies with the highest average scores for onstage interviews, swimsuits, and evening gowns, at that point, will become the finalists.
That's very clear. Thanks,
hope.
Jane. Those interviews will begin in just a moment. Right now, time out for this word from Extra Action Tide.
This is one of my favorite parts of the pageant. Having seen these girls, we now have a chance to get to know them a little better. I'm going to visit briefly with each contestant, and at the end of each of these visits, you at home will see the computer's average of the judges' scores for this interview part of the competition. Now, Miss Nebraska, will you step down to me first? She is Becky Staub, 18 years old, Ralston, Nebraska, studying business at the University of Nebraska.
That's right.
And what are your plans for the future?
Well, after I graduate, I plan on going into work with the travel industry, either working with an airline or having my own travel agency.
Well, that would be very nice. How did you center on travel? Why did you choose that?
Well, I like to travel, and so I figure you may as well get a job that you enjoy. And I want to see the world, and I mean, more than see it, I want to experience with the people, and I like it.
I think that's a fine idea. Now, I read in your biography that you are a four-point student, a straight-A student.
That's right.
I think that's fine. Now, you have a lot of fine football players up there at the University of Nebraska, don't you?
Uh-huh.
Do these fellers ever call you and want you to tutor them?
Well, I've had a few wrestlers, but I'm open for football
wrestlers.
Players, too.
You got to watch them. But you do some tutoring, do you?
Well, not. I mean, it's just on my own. It's not like a job or anything like that. I just try to help them out.
Well, let's forget the Nebraska boys for a moment. What do you think of these southern gentlemen down here in Mississippi?
Oh, if I could find one to marry.
Would you they're like all, to marry one?
Well, I mean, not now, but they're also, you know, polite.
I hear a volunteer in the balcony right now. They're also what?
They're all polite, and they really know how to treat you like a lady, and they really put southern hospitality into actions more than just words.
Well, I think that was very well said. Thank you, Mr. Nebraska. If you watch your screen at home, you will see the score that she has received. We're ready for you, Miss Arizona. Miss Arizona is Janine Ford. She is 20 years old. She lives in Gilbert, Arizona. She's a student at Arizona State University, and you shared the most photogenic award with Miss Ohio, didn't you?
Yes, I sure did, Bob.
And that must have been a thrill to
Quite
receive thrill. This from the photographers covering the pageant.
Yes, it was thrilling. I haven't done any professional modeling as such, and now I've had several offers. So it's very flattering, really.
I am very proud of you. Now, you're going to Arizona State. What are you studying there?
Business communications.
And what do you want to do eventually?
Well, right now I'm with a major newspaper in Phoenix, and I'm in public relations. I love my job. And maybe hope to go into more public relations, working with people, this kind of thing.
Is that why you were making these notes? I've seen you making notes on everything going on here. What are you going to do with those?
Oh, yes. I am. The paper is having me keep a diary of several things that happened throughout the pageant. And I must say, it's very interesting. Very interesting.
You're going to write something for the paper?
No, I won't be writing it as such. They're going to go through my notes after the state director and everyone just kind of skims through them to make sure. And then they'll take what they want and make an article.
Well, remember, it's B-O-B, B-A-R-K-E-R.
You're loved, definitely.
Handsome, debonair, modest.
Young at heart.
Young at heart, right. Thank you, Miss Arizona.
Thank you.
Now I'd like to talk with you, Miss South Carolina. She is Shawn Nichols Weatherly. She's 20 years old. She lives in Sumter, South Carolina. She's a communications major at Clemson University. And what are your plans for the future?
Well, I'm minoring in communications right now at Clemson because they don't provide a major. So this summer, I'm hoping that I can get some practical experience and maybe find a school that'll offer the major.
You know, tonight you don't look at all worried, and yet I know that you've had a very trying week.
Oh, no, not that again.
Haven't you?
Yes,
you know
I have.
You know what she did? She invited her boyfriend to come down here for the week with all these pretty girls.
Dumb. Oh, that was so dumb.
During rehearsals, he has taken a picture of every girl in this pageant, hasn't he?
Yes, I'm going to go through the negatives and get rid of those.
I was talking with him. He said he didn't even have film in the camera part of the time.
Well, no, sometimes he does, but most of the time he's just trying to get a little closer to the girls.
This boyfriend of hers is a professional football player for the San Francisco 49ers, isn't he?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, and you're clear down there in South Carolina.
Yeah, we have large telephone bills. I've considered owning stock in Southern Bell.
He's thrown the longest passes in football from California to South
Carolina. Longest passes off the field right here.
Where is he? You want to blow him a kiss here before you?
I think he's up there, but he may be around taking some more pictures.
Do you want to whip a kiss in his direction?
No matter. It doesn't know. I don't know where it's
going. He's a wide receiver. If he doesn't catch that, he should get another job. Anyway.
That's right.
Thank you very much, Miss South Carolina. Miss Minnesota, will you come over here to me? She is Carla Peterson. She's 19. She's studying speech communications at the University of Minnesota. And as part of your education, you are working at a television station, are you not?
Yes, I am. I'm working at KSTP-TV.
Well, tell us what you're doing. Tell us all about it.
All right, I'm an intern in production at the Twin Cities Today Show.
An intern?
Yes, an intern. I work through the university, and I get 5 credits also for my job. It's an interesting story, if I may tell you, about how I got on camera for the first time.
You may tell me, yes.
Okay. When I was participating in the Miss Minnesota pageant, and we had a spot open on the show Monday, this was Friday, that I was speaking to my producer, and I had an idea that I could book the winner of the Miss Minnesota pageant for the show on Monday. Mm-hmm. And the producer said, yes, that would be a great idea. Why don't you do that? So I participated in the pageant through the weekend, and I won the title of Miss Minnesota. So I came to work in the morning for the show when I was supposed to bring along the winner, and I had my sash and my crown on. And I walked into the station, and they all looked at me, and they just went wild. I booked myself, really, for the show.
So you ended up talking to yourself?
Well, no. I talked with the host of the show.
Well, I'm very proud of you, and I'm sure the station in Minnesota is proud of you, too. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Miss Texas, let's talk it over. Miss Texas is Barbara Buckley. She's 22. And I can tell there's some cowboys here. She's from Midland, Texas. She's a graduate of Angelo State University with a Bachelor of Arts degree in drama. And what do you plan to do with that?
Well, I'm working toward a career in the theater. My forte is musical comedy because I love to sing and dance. And hopefully I will maybe have some TV offers or do some modeling now that, as Janine said, some doors have been opened for me too. I have a chance to model now. But eventually I will be in the theater somewhere. I hope to own my own.
Good for you.
Dinner theater.
Now, all of you girls are so beautiful and so healthy looking. Do you actually prepare for a pageant? What did you do?
Oh, sure. When I was in Midland, I'd go running real late at night, and I'd swim 4 or 5 times a day, ride my bicycle 10 miles, and I'd run 3 and walk 5, and I did nothing but exercise. And when I've been on the road traveling throughout the Lone Star State, sometimes I'm in the hotel room, and I'm pounding away on the walls, and sometimes I get calls saying, "But you quiet that girl down, I'm running in place."
All that may help, but it doesn't hurt to be 22 years old, too. Thank you very much, Miss Texas. Miss Florida, would you step out here to me, please? Miss Florida is Barbara Bowser, age 20, home Miami Springs, Florida. And what do you do, Barbara?
Well, I teach a gymnastics class, I work at a tennis court, running the pro shop, and I also go to school and have a boyfriend.
Well, you are a busy little girl.
I certainly am.
What ages are your students in the gymnastics class?
My gymnastics class ages start at 3 till up to 16.
Would you like to continue with this, or what are your plans?
I certainly would. When I go back home, I'd like to finish my education, and I also like to do some modeling, and I would like to continue with gymnastics because it keeps me in shape, and I really enjoy it.
A lot of the girls have rooting sections at home. How about you? Do you have one?
I certainly do. Unfortunately, my family's not here tonight because I've only been Miss Florida for 3 weeks, so they're all sitting in front of the television set right now watching me, and they're all excited.
I'll bet they are. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Set her score now, as we have with the others. And these are the first 6 of our semifinalists. I wonder if one of them might become Miss USA tonight.
We've seen the first 6 interviews and the scores that they received. Now, to use a phrase we'll be hearing a lot in this election year, let's go to our computer for an analysis of the trends.
Well, Helen, it's a little early yet, with only half of the precincts having been heard from in this early round. But the front runner at this point happens to be, we're still getting in some of these scores over here, but we know who's in first position, Miss South Carolina, and that's a 9.082, Helen.
That's something. Now I know how Walter Cronkite feels. There are still 6 more semifinalists to be interviewed, which may or may not cause some changes in the front runners. But before that happens, let's listen to these words from Downy Fabric Softener.
And now that we know a little something about 6 of our semifinalists, let's learn a little bit about the other 6. Miss Alabama, would you come down here to me, please? In your case, I feel as if I should stand back here to interview you, Miss Alabama. You, how many accidents have you been involved in since you got here?
I think 5.
Let me explain. This is Pamela Riga. She's 19. She's a sophomore at Troy State University. And she had a master plan for winning. She was going to put the other girls in the hospital and win by default. How many girls have been involved in these
Well, I hit incident. Miss Missouri with the banjo and ran her hose and pulled a mop. I didn't mean to. And then I hit Miss New Mexico in the head with my arm. And I hit somebody else with a chair when I was lifting it up. I've been hitting everybody, but I fell up the stairs too, and I have a big cut.
And she tried to tell us that all of these things were accidents, which I'm sure they were. What are you studying at Troy State?
I'm in economics and finance.
What do you want to do?
Well, hopefully someday I would like to be able to work either for a lawyer or for a political campaign, do the background.
Would you like to go into politics yourself?
Oh, I don't know. I would like to if I can, if I find that all goes well and
why,
I feel that I'm suited for it.
Why are you interested in politics?
It's about the only thing that really gets me excited and gets me going. I enjoy it very much. I think that it's very important for all of us to be interested in politics and what is going on with our world.
What do you promise to do if elected?
Lower taxes.
I'll vote for you. Thank you, Ms. Alabama. I'll vote for you. She got several votes for that. That's her score now. And Miss New Mexico. She is Kathy Patrick. She is 19. She is a sophomore at the University of Texas at El Paso. And what are you studying, Miss New Mexico?
I'm a Soviet studies major. It's a
history
Soviet
major. Soviet studies? What yes. do you propose to do?
Well, I'd like to go study in Leningrad when I'm a senior. If relations continue to deteriorate, I doubt I'll be able to do that. But that's been one of my big ambitions. They have a program for language majors. I'm not a language major, but I will have sufficient credits to be able to go and study there.
Would you speak some Russian now?
Oh, yes. I do.
Would you like to say a few words to this nice audience in Russian?
Somehow, I knew you'd do this to me. Let me think. Okay. Dobraya vecherna. Меня зовут Катя. Я думаю, что здесь это очень симпатичные люди, и я очень люблю ваш красивый море.
I think she said she likes The Price is Right.
Yes.
What did you say?
No, I said, good evening, my name is Kathy, and I think that the people here are very friendly, and I love your ocean. Where I come from, there's no water.
Miss New Mexico, I think in English or in Russian, you did it very nicely. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Bye-bye. We'll see what Miss New Mexico has as a score, and then we will talk with Miss Maryland. Miss Maryland is Tanya Walker, age 19, from Kingsville, Maryland, and she is a communications major at Towson or Towson?
Towson.
At Towson State University, and what do you want to do?
I would like to go into television journalism.
Mm-hmm.
I would like to be an actress. I'd like to sing, I'd like to dance, but I think everyone here would be interested in show business, it seems like. So my favorite thing right now is television.
And you scouted the pageant last year here on the Mississippi Gulf Coast, didn't you?
Yes, I did.
You came to the rehearsals.
Right.
You saw the girls complaining about how their feet hurt.
And hurt, and hurt.
And right. How hungry they were.
Exactly.
And how tired they
and
were.
And I still came.
And you thought, I want to be a part of that.
I sure did.
Have you suffered so much?
No, not at all.
You've had fun, haven't you?
Yes, well, I've had the most wonderful time of my life.
It's been fun having you here. Thank you, Miss Maryland.
Thank you.
After showing you her score, we will call Miss New Hampshire to the microphone. She is Eva Dyer from Amherst. She's an honor graduate of the University of New Hampshire with a degree in business administration. But in the opening number, you were dancing beautifully.
Well, I thank you. And I studied 10 years of dance, and I decided I didn't want to stand in the unemployment line, so I decided to get my business degree instead. But I still love it. It's home.
Well, you dance like a dream.
Thank you.
What, now that you have your degree, what does the future hold for you?
Well, I hope to get my MBA and probably do a concentration in finance, and eventually with that do the business report on TV. And that's a pretty definite goal, and there's very few slots for that, but I hope I'm one of them.
South Carolina is your roommate.
That's right.
How are you getting along with that rebel?
Beautifully.
I'll bet you are.
We're catching each other's accents.
And you, yes. I think, are the only two girls in the semifinals who are our roommate. What room are you in?
I shouldn't give that out over the air.
Whisper in my ear. If you're in Las Vegas, play number 502. Thank you, Miss New Hampshire. I want to talk with you, Miss Kentucky. Miss Kentucky is Lisa Louise DeVille, age 19, from Owensboro, a student at Murray State University. And what are you studying?
Political science, a pre-law major.
You're a pre-law major?
Mm-hmm.
And why did you choose the law?
Well, I was always fascinated with law and government classes, and I love politics, so I thought that's the best way to get on the sure foot. So.
And attorneys also make a lot of money.
Yeah, that's an added.
Have you ever watched our pageant at home? And
when I was a little girl, I did.
Did you?
Yeah, and I always thought the girls were so glamorous, and now that I'm here, I wonder. No, I didn't. But, and I always thought it would be wonderful to be here, and it really is.
Well, it's wonderful to have you here.
I'm glad you
got here before I was hobbling around on my cane.
Well, I'm glad I did, too.
Thank you, Miss Kentucky.
Thank you.
One more girl, and she is Miss New York, Deborah Sue Maurice, 21, New York City, an actress. And what are your career ambitions?
Well, right now I'm living in New York City, and I'm trying to do a few national commercials and a soap opera just for fun, and then I think I'd like to get into sports broadcasting.
Oh, you would? Do you have a background in sports?
Well, I have a boyfriend who plays in sports.
Who's your boyfriend?
His name is George Brett. He plays third base for Kansas City.
George Brett is one of the finest players in baseball, and he's your boyfriend.
He sure is. At least he was before I left.
Well, I'm sure he still is. You suppose old George is watching us tonight?
I'm sure he is.
Not playing ball tonight, huh?
Well, today's his birthday. He has the day off.
Oh, is this his birthday?
Mm-hmm.
Wouldn't it be nice to take him the Miss USA crown? He couldn't wear that on third base, though, could he?
Well, when I asked him what he wanted for his birthday, he said Miss USA. And I said, well, you do know that Miss USA does a lot of traveling. And he says, well, how about a new shirt?
Thank you very much, Miss New York. A check of her score. And you've had a chance to meet our 12 semifinalists. I'm wondering if you at home have changed your minds about your earlier selections, or are you more sure than ever?
I thought I'd come down here to the judges' box and demonstrate for you just how our voting system works. After each girl's informal interview with Bob Barker, which we just saw, of course, each judge decided on a score for that girl. Well, let me tell you something. They punched it right into this terminal, right here. For example, every girl would love to have the judge give her a score of 9.99, which would be done like this. 9.99. The computer then absorbs all the scores from the judges and comes up with an average for each girl. The same procedure would be followed for the swimsuit and evening gown competition a little later. But now, all 12 girls have had the scores for their interview segment registered in the computer. And Jane is ready for us at the tote board with the results. Go ahead, Jane.
Before we get into that, Helen, I'd like to first thank two former Miss USA's lovely ladies, Barbara Peterson and Kim Tones, for their help with the tote board, and I'm going to need it tonight. We see that our first half leader, Miss South Carolina, maintained her lead in this right now. She has a 9.082. This is where we're going to keep our composite scores, and this is the individual for the categories. In second position, Miss Florida with a 9.029, and Kentucky in third position with an 8.989. Very, very close at this point. Back to you, Helen.
If your favorite contestant got a high score, keep thinking the good thoughts. But if she didn't, don't give up hope. There are still two more chances for her to catch up or even pull ahead. Now let's pause with this message from Cascade.
Musical tastes, being what they are, is sometimes difficult to have a musical star on this show who is a favorite with young people and with their parents as well. Tonight, we have a singer who fills the bill perfectly. Last summer, he was with us in Australia for the Miss Universe pageant, and he was truly sensational. We feel most fortunate to welcome back tonight the exciting young superstar, Donny Osmond!
time for wondering why. It's here, the moment is now about to decide. Let them believe, leaving behind. Keep me in your heart. No, whatever you do, you're by your side.
Pleasant duty to perform right now. I get to introduce the panel of judges to you, in whose hands rests the decision as to who will become Miss USA of 1980. But before I do that, just one personal note. This is a very, very important night for these contestants, and this celebrity panel has been especially aware of their responsibilities to these lovely young ladies. Their dedication deserves congratulations. So now let me introduce them to you. First of all, the well-known actor and star of the Emmy Award-winning show, Room 222, Lloyd Haynes. Next, an author whose book sales have surpassed 24 million, the author of The Crowd Pleasers, Rosemary Rogers. One of the most famous American artists whose art style is so unique that it bears his name, Peter Max. One of our country's most successful models and 1978's Miss USA, Judy Anderson. One of the outstanding American authorities on opera, associate editor of Opera News and Ballet News, Gerald Fitzgerald. Having appeared on more than 50 covers of national fashion magazines, one of our America's best-known fashion models has just finished filming the Michael Cimino's picture, Heaven's Gate. Roseanne Villa. Although he is a lecturer, writer, and internationally known expert on telepathy and all forms of psychic phenomena, his ability to mysteriously bend silverware makes him a doubtful dinner guest. Ladies and gentlemen, Uri Geller. Star of the hit movie Smile, and now a star of the hit television series Eight is Enough, Joan Prather. From Shakespeare to musical comedy to commercials to the role of Larry in the smash comedy series Three's Company, Richard Klein. Our next judge is not only an outstanding Broadway and television singer and dancer, but also a Tony Award-winning actress, Anita Gillette. One of America's great comic strip heroes was born on the easel of this next gentleman. He was the creator of Batman, Bob Kane. Now, our final judge has starred on Broadway, in the movies, and of course on television. Holy Miss USA pageant, Batman, it's you, Adam West. Thank you, judges, and thank you, ladies and gentlemen.
What a pleasure to listen to Donny Osmond sing again. Of course, in his family, everybody sings. In my family, my four daughters, four, won't even try to carry a tune. Right now, we're standing backstage and trying very hard not to get anybody's way. There are lights to be checked, scenery to be moved, and in the midst of all this, we can feel the tension starting to increase. Now, let me tell you about some of these things. These are called chaser lights, and they tell Gary Woodring here how his patterns are working on the stage. And these two boards over here comprise a memory system, which makes possible an unlimited number of lighting moves. The swimsuit competition is coming up next, to be followed by the evening gown competition, and suddenly our 12 semifinalists will turn into our five finalists. How are you judges at home doing so far? I want to grab one of these. Miss Alabama, come over here. I want to know if you're nervous.
Yes.
What are you going to do to get over that?
Take a big deep breath and go out and do the best I can.
What are you going to think about?
Going to think about happiness and thanks.
And winning.
And that too.
Well, good luck to you.
Thank you.
And to all the girls. More from the Miss USA pageant after this from Dry Formula Sure.
As we mentioned, there are three categories of competition for our semifinalists. And the time has come now for the second category, the swimsuit competition. Once again, while each girl models her swimsuit, the judges will put their individual scores for each girl into the computer. And the computer will tabulate an average score for that girl. Only you viewers at home will get to see that score. Here now, 12 of America's loveliest young women in the 1980 Miss USA swimsuit competition. Miss Nebraska.
Becky has blonde hair and brown eyes. She's 18 years old, she weighs 112 pounds, and she's 5 feet 6 inches tall.
Miss Arizona.
Janine is 20 years of age, 5 feet 9 inches tall, and weighs 120 pounds. Her hair is blonde, and her eyes are gray.
Miss South Carolina.
She's 20 years old, weighs 116 pounds, and she's 5 feet 8 inches tall.
Miss Minnesota.
Carla is a blonde with green eyes. She's 19 years old, 5 feet 10 inches tall, and weighs 125 pounds.
Miss Texas.
Barbara is a 22-year-old brunette with brown eyes. She's 5 feet 8 inches tall and weighs 119 pounds.
Miss Florida.
Blonde with blue eyes. She weighs 110
inches tall, and she's 20 years old.
Miss Alabama.
Pamela has dark brown hair and brown eyes. She is 19 years old, 5 feet 9 inches tall, and weighs 125 pounds.
Miss New Mexico.
19-year-old Kathy is 5 feet 7 inches tall and weighs 117 pounds. She has brown hair and green eyes.
New Hampshire.
At 25 years of age, Eva is 5 feet 7 and a half inches tall and weighs 122 pounds. She has hazel eyes and auburn hair.
Miss Kentucky.
19-year-old Lisa has honey brown hair and green eyes. She weighs 115 pounds and she's 5 feet 8 inches tall.
Miss New York.
21-year-old Deborah has hazel eyes and brown hair. She's 5 feet 7 inches tall and weighs 105 pounds.
And there are the 12 semifinalists in tonight's swimsuit competition.
Jane is at the tote board where the computer scores are being posted. And we'll both be back after this message from All Temperature Cheer.
The board shows that we did not have a change in our number one position. Miss South Carolina is still in the lead with a 9.097. The second place runner is right now in the swimsuit competition, mind you, is Florida with an 8.953. And third place in this particular event is Alabama with an 8.775. Remember, our composite totals are over there. So, Helen, it is still too close to call.
Thank you, Jane. I'm here in the dressing room with some of our 12 semifinalists. And again, I point out to you that these girls do not know the scores that you do know. And this interview has no effect on the scoring, I might add. I want to talk to one of you. Come on, let me talk to you. Miss New Mexico. Everyone can sort of imagine how you must be feeling right now, but we really don't know, so you tell us.
Oh, I'm just thrilled. It's such a big thing for me to be here. I'm from a small town, and I've never been on television except once, and it's just so exciting. Oh.
You're sure on it now?
It's just such a thrill for me.
Good luck, sweetheart.
Thank
Good luck
you.
To all of you ladies. And now back to the stage and Bob Barker.
While Miss USA contestants are not judged on their ability to sing and dance, over the years we have found how much they all enjoy taking part in our annual production number. This year, it's a salute to the minstrel shows and their music. the minstrel shows that were so much a part of the early days along and on the Mississippi. Ladies!
Mississippi on Miss USA. Yes, I'm a minstrel man.
He's a minstrel man, straight from Alabama.
You can have your ragtime and all of that jazz. I'll take Mississippi with its razzmatazz. Yes, I'm a minstrel man.
He's a minstrel man.
Take me back to Dixie.
Contestants will leave here with the title of Miss USA. It's also true that all 51 will leave here with a memory of a wonderful two-week stay on the beautiful Mississippi Gulf Coast. Some of it involved some work, but a lot of it was just pure fun. Just watch. We've all seen bumper cars, but down here the girls had fun with bumper boats. Look out! By ocean standards, this may not be called surfing, but this isn't an ocean. This is the Waveland Pool. The beach at the Royal d'Iberville Hotel was the setting for an oyster party. Oh, shucks. You know, that's a real local delicacy. Oh, gosh, I wish I had one of those. A local fisherman gave the girls a lesson in crabbing. And then a local crab gave the fisherman a lesson. The girls went on a fishing trip into the Gulf of Mexico, and they came back with that evening's dinner. Wearing Vicki Vaughn dresses, the girls attended a makeup clinic hosted by a famous cosmetic company and received some beauty tips, as well as some answers to their beauty questions. Pretty, pretty. It wouldn't be the South without a square dance.
So the girls went to Columbia for the first annual Celebration South. They were wearing jean wear and active wear from Gloria Vanderbilt by Mirjani. You like pancakes? Well, so do our candidates. So much so that they had a pancake eating contest. Oh, yummy. I don't think anybody's going to want lunch too soon. The winner. Another disco? Not exactly. The girls added a new twist this year, roller skates. The aircraft carrier Peleliu was the site of a press day. The girls were introduced to naval signal flags. And then the crew came up with a very special salute of their own. So far, our semifinalists have been judged in swimsuit and interviews. Coming right up will be the evening gown competition, which they will be judged again, after which we'll be down to our five finalists. Right now, let's pause for this word from Safeguard Deodorant Soap.
With us tonight are two gentlemen representing our host state. Please welcome Mississippi's Lieutenant Governor Brad Dye and the Speaker of the House, C.E. Buddy Newman. The evening gown competition will bring us, each semi-finalist, modeling an evening gown of her own choosing. Our panel of judges will give her a score based on poise, charm, and a flair for fashion. Once again, you at home will get to see the totals as the computer averages the 12 judges' score for each girl. And since this weekend we celebrate Armed Forces Day, it's only fitting that our escorts for the young ladies should be members of the United States Marine Corps, and that we should hear a salute to America and the Southland from the Naval Air Training Command Choir. This USA Evening Gown Competition.
Dixieland, that's where I was born.
Miss Nebraska.
Early Lord, one frosty morn. Look away, look away, look away, Dixieland. Oh, I wish I was in Dixie.
South Carolina.
Sit all night and listen.
is Texas.
This land is your land. This land is my land. From California to the New York Island. From the rest
is Florida.
Gowns, and the judges here have made their selections. How about you? How do your selections compare with those of our judges? So you can find out, let's go to Jane at our tote board.
Well, Helen, in the evening gown competition, these scores came in so fast, I hope I'm right. The judges gave the highest mark in that particular segment to Miss South Carolina, a 9.567, and that's quite a big jump to the second place with an 8.701, who is Miss Arizona, and Miss Kentucky down here with an 8.457. So you watch these very carefully because you know this cumulative column over here is the one that really counts. And I'm not going to tell you. I'm going to go back to Helen so you can't even see it.
Well, the competition isn't over yet by a long shot, Jane. Right now, our computer scores are being verified by our accountants. And in just a minute, Bob Barker will be introducing our five finalists. First, though, let's pause for this word from Rely.
title Miss USA carries with it great prestige, but it also has rewards beyond that. Miss USA 1980 will receive $21,000 in cash as part of an overall prize package, which includes the following: the International Flemington Fur Company, a natural Black Llama Ranch mink coat, modeled here by Miss USA 1977, beautiful Kim Tones, a fabulous wardrobe of dresses designed by Vicki Vaughn. Here are Kim and Lisa McArdle in two of Vicki Vaughn's winning looks for young ladies in the swing of things. Maybelline, the official cosmetics for the 1980 Miss USA pageant, will present our new winner with $5,000 in cash, plus a 5-year supply of Maybelline cosmetics. A wardrobe by Roberta of California in soft, sensuous Celesta fabric made by Roselawn Industries. Monarch Coat Company will present Miss USA with a high-performance, 17-foot, McFast sport fishing boat, equipped with many luxurious features. From the Bulova Watch Company, Miss USA will receive this Accutron quartz watch with 24 diamonds in a 14-karat solid gold case and a matching bracelet. A $3,500 Sarah Coventry cash scholarship, plus a collection of Sarah Coventry jewelry, including the beautiful Miss USA crown. Miss USA will win a $5,000 cash award, plus a year-round wardrobe of the latest jeanwear fashions from Gloria Vanderbilt by Mirjani, including these stylish outfits worn by Kim and Lisa. Shea's Model A and Model T car company and participating Ford and Lincoln Mercury dealers will present to Miss USA this reproduction of the 1955 Thunderbird. Just as this summer's political conventions will narrow the field of candidates to two, so do we find our field has narrowed now to five. Which five, you ask? Well, we're about to find out. And in addition, you folks at home will be able to see the scores that our judges gave each of the finalists. As before, the names will not be called in any particular order. Now, may I have the computer results, please? Thank you. Here are the names of our five finalists. First, Miss Florida. Finalist number two, Miss South Carolina. Our third finalist is Miss Alabama. And Miss Kentucky. Last girl who has a chance to be Miss USA of 1980 is Miss Arizona. Congratulations, finalists. One of you will be on your way to Seoul, Korea to take part in the Miss Universe pageant as Miss USA.
Now, let's take a look at our computer board again and see which of our finalists had the highest score of all. Jane, tell us about it.
Well, Helen, the way I have it, and if you've been watching the entire evening, you know that the front runner all evening long has been Miss South Carolina, and right now her cumulative is 9.249. Now, the story here, though, is Arizona, Florida, Alabama, and Kentucky have been switching positions, Helen, throughout the entire competition.
Well, that's what happens, I guess. But
yes.
Now, the time has come, Bob would say, as everyone would say, say goodbye to our tour board. From now on, previous scores don't matter. We're just going to erase them all through the magic of Jane Kennedy.
Well, are you sure this one's going to work, Helen?
Jane, on live television, you're never sure of anything, but shall we try?
You got a point there. Okay. See there? Just when you did it. Okay. Go ahead. I think that winds up the balloting. And all the balloting right now is going to be done by hand anyway, so that winds up my role for the evening. And I think I'll just slip into the audience and watch the big moment coming up.
Anything you slip into, you're going to be noticed. You know that, don't you?
I'll see if I can sneak around the back somewhere.
You did a wonderful job, as always.
Thank you,
Jane. You really did. Such a pleasure to work with you.
It's my pleasure.
I'm going to be looking forward to our working together again in Korea.
Yeah, that I'm really looking forward to. You know, the people coming up to here, I think I can look over everybody. Right?
Everybody comes up to you here.
Not quite.
Now let's see what kind of magic Bob has for us on stage. Bob?
I am going to ask each of our five finalists a different question. While they're giving their spontaneous and unrehearsed answers, the judges here will be marking handwritten ballots, choosing four runners-up and Miss USA of 1980. In this bowl that Barbara Peterson has, we have five questions, and each of our finalists will have an opportunity to select one of the questions, beginning with you, Miss South Carolina. Take any one you wish. Your question is, what person in public life would you most want to be like?
There's so many people that I admire different aspects of their life, but if I had one person to pick out, I think I'd pick Barbara Walters, as some may disagree, but she has so many different areas in her life where she meets so many people. That's one thing I'd envy in her, is to be able to meet so many people and be able to talk with strangers that she hardly knows as if they were her friends. I think she would be one person I would be like, would most like to be like.
Thank you, Miss South Carolina. Miss Kentucky, reach into the bowl, please, and pull out a question. Your question is, where in the world would you most like to go and why? Where in the world would you most like to go and why?
Well, I think I would like to go to Paris, France, because... because I've never been anywhere as glamorous and has the awe to it as Paris has. And also, I took 5 years of French, and I would like to see how much of it I remember. And I think I would enjoy meeting all the French people.
Thank you, Miss Kentucky. And now, Miss Arizona, will you select a question, please? Miss Arizona, your question is, would you rather have lived in your grandmother's time or now?
Goodness, my grandmother's time or now? My grandmother, by the way, she's here all the way from Washington State visiting me tonight, a very special lady, and I know she had a very happy life, and I'm sure whichever lifetime I would have lived in, I'd enjoy myself and have a happy life.
Thank you, Miss Arizona. On we go to Miss Alabama. Her question is there a book, movie, or television show that has affected your life?
No. No. I enjoy reading and I enjoy watching movies, but there's really nothing that has affected my life more than the people who I've met along the way and everything that I've experienced. A movie, a book, everything you realize, most of the time, they're not exactly the way that they happen. I think you have to put your feet down on the earth and experience life.
Thank you, Miss Alabama. Last question is yours, Miss Florida. Miss Florida, your question. What have you learned from being a Miss USA contestant?
Well, I've learned that it's... excuse me. I've learned that it's not the most important thing to come in here to win. It's to have a good time and to gain a great experience. I think that if you come in with the attitude of having a good time and enjoying yourself and meeting new people, you just can't lose.
Thank you, Miss Florida. Thank you, girls. Listen, listen, listen. Do you hear singing?
Is it true what they say about Dixie? Does the sun really shine all the time? The sweet magnolias blossom around everybody's door. The folks keep eating possum till they can't eat no more. Is it true what they say
about Swanee is the dream by that stream so sublime. Do they laugh? Do they love like they say in every song? If it's true, that's where I belong. And if you spend some time, as we have, on the beautiful Mississippi Gulf Coast, you find it is true what they say about Dixie, especially about this beautiful state, really beautiful. And here to show us and tell us about the great heritage of Mississippi is Miss USA of 1975, Summer Bartholomew.
Hello and welcome to the Mississippi Queen. They have a saying in this state, Mississippi doesn't live in the past, but the past lives in Mississippi.
Tradition lives, too, in the cities of today's Mississippi. Here are Natchez. Visitors from all over the world come to see the magnificent antebellum mansions like Dunley, with its 26 Tuscan columns behind 1,000 feet of cast iron fence. Stanton Hall. Construction began in 1851 and was completed in 1858, almost 130 years ago. And this is Longwood, with a story all its own. In June 1861, the construction on this unusual octagonal exterior, along with the richly decorated first floor, was completed. Unfortunately, due to the war, the job was interrupted, and the upper floors remained unfinished in one of America's truly unique homes.
Welcome back to the river. We're now heading for Vicksburg. A unique feature of the riverboats was the calliope. Just on the other side of those trees is the Vicksburg National Military Park.
Nearly 1,800 acres are dedicated to the brave people on both sides of the war between the states. The Alabama Memorial exemplifies the spirit of the women who dedicated their support during the 47-day siege of Vicksburg. One of the most impressive sights and the largest monument in the park is the Illinois Memorial, a dome that echoes the ravages and history of the Civil War. From the vantage point of Fort Nogales, one can truly sense the scope of the war that divided our nation.
Now it's time to move on through the yesterdays and todays that comprise the great state of Mississippi and head back to Biloxi and our date with the future Miss USA. Now to you, Helen.
Thank you, Summer. The Miss USA pageant will be right back after this word from Camay for your beautiful complexion.
For the next few minutes, two gentlemen from the internationally known accounting firm of Ernst & Whinney will be doing our final tabulating. We're going to use that time to treat our ears to the musical talents of Donny Osmond and treat our eyes to another look at the lovely faces of our five finalists.
Whenever I see your smiling face, I have to smile myself, 'cause I love you. Yes, I do. When you give me that pretty little pout, it turns me inside out. There's something about you, baby. Tell me how much longer it'll go stronger every day. Oh, how much longer? Thought I was in love a couple of times before with the girl next door, but that was long before I met you. Now I'm sure I won't forget you. Now I thank my lucky star that you are who you are, not just another lovely lady. Longer, it'll go stronger every day. Don't go changing to try and please me. Never let me down before. Don't imagine.
familiar. I'd take you just the way you are. Oh, need to know that you will always be the same old song that I knew. Oh, what will it take till you believe in me? Way that I believe. I said I love you, that's forever, and this I promise from the heart. I couldn't love you any better. I love you just the way you are. I was alone, I took a ride, I didn't know what I would find there. Up the road, maybe I could see another man of mine there. Ooh, and then I suddenly see you. And did I tell you that I need you every single day of my life?
Take her title proudly to Seoul, Korea for the Miss Universe pageant, which will bring together beautiful women from about 80 countries. That pageant will be televised live via satellite on CBS on the night of July 7th. And here with us now to talk about our trip to Korea is the current Miss Universe Venezuela's beautiful Maritza Sagilero. Hi. I'm just fine. You've been to Korea, haven't you?
Yes, exactly. I've been in Korea about 1 month ago. I saw the theater, beautiful theater, big and new. And Seoul is beautiful city too, so nice people. I am enjoying there.
Well, that's terrific, of course, we're going back. In the meantime, I'd like to show you some drawings by our art director, Don Shirley, of what the sets will look like. Aren't they just beautiful?
Yes, look like it's Korea.
Yeah,
isn't
that great? There's another one.
Great.
That's where you're gonna have to surrender your crown, you know.
I know.
I have to congratulate you on how well you've learned the English language. When we met about 10 months ago in this Universe pageant, you spoke no English at all. Now you understand it and speak it so beautifully.
Yeah. Thank you, Helen.
You make us all feel stupid. It's nice to see you, darling.
Thank you, Van.
While we're all looking forward to Korea, here on the Gulf Coast, the moment we've been waiting for is only 90 seconds away. Meantime, let's hear this word for crest.
A year ago here on the Gulf Coast, a young lady from Rochester, New York, had her dream come true when she was chosen Miss USA of 1979. In just a few moments, she'll crown her successor. But first, we'd like to have her take her traditional walk and deliver her words of farewell. Here is Miss USA 1979, Mary Therese Friel.
People ask me, what can possibly follow being Miss USA? Well, my plans are to model while I continue pursuing my law degree. But no matter what the future holds for me, a highlight of my life will have to be the year I spent as Miss USA. It would be impossible to thank everyone for the many kindnesses I've received, but my gratitude is very sincere, and so are my best wishes to the girl who's about to embark on that wonderful experience.
Thank you, Mary Therese. Our accountants have just handed me the all-important list. On this card are the judges' final decisions, four runners-up at Miss USA 1980. Before I read it, I want to say to our five finalists that we would be happy and proud to have any one of you become Miss USA. Now, I shall begin. I shall begin with the fourth runner-up. And the fourth runner-up is Miss Kentucky. The second runner-up is Miss Alabama. A third runner-up. Well done, Miss Alabama. The second runner-up is Miss Florida. One of you is about to become Miss USA of 1980. The other will be the first runner-up, and of course that's an important position because if for any reason Miss USA cannot fulfill her obligation, the first runner-up becomes Miss USA. I will announce the first runner-up first, and then Miss USA. The first runner-up is Miss Arizona. Miss South Carolina is Miss USA. USA. You've won all of the cash awards and the magnificent prizes, and I'd like to have you step right out there now as Mary Therese Friel reads the Miss USA brief.
We, the young women of the United States of America, believe people everywhere are seeking peace, tolerance, and mutual understanding. We pledge to spread this message in every way we can, wherever we go.
20-year-old Shawn Nichols Weatherly is the new Miss USA. She hails from Sumter, South Carolina, attends Clemson University. She hopes for a career in modeling or public relations. She enjoys dancing, skating, tennis, and swimming. Her hair is blonde, her eyes are blue. She's 5'8" tall, and she weighs 116 pounds. And she's gorgeous.
Now, this is Bob Barker thanking you for joining us and saying good night, everybody.
On Monday, July 7th for the Miss Universe pageant, live from Seoul, Republic of Korea. This is Dick Lamb speaking. Thank you.